Hello, welcome to my garden again. It's an absolutely beautiful day again, so I couldn't resist to get outside and do another one. No Molly at the moment, fingers crossed. She only steal my show. Today, I've got something quite special. First of all, I'd like to say thank you to Amanda Hunt, who sent me and the Real Ale Guide some really, really good beers. The Fuller's Reserves, and she also sent a few glasses. I've got one today to use, and what I've decided to do today is actually a one-off beer. It was made to celebrate the 300th birthday of the Ascot Race Course, so here it is, and hence the horse on the actual photograph there. And the good old Griffin Brewery bit up there. So yeah, Amanda, thank you so much for sending us these things. It's taken me a little while to get around to doing one of your beers, but here I am today and I'm going to do it. So if we go have a look a little bit, I've got some history here regarding the race course. I think it was opened in 1711 by Queen Anne, and the first race that was held was called, I've forgotten the name, so just look. It was Her Majesty's Plate. So this was the 300th beer, 1711 to 2011. Can you see on there? I'm not sure if you can, it's so bright. Glares in my eye, so I couldn't tell you. So this one here is a bottle conditioned ale. I can see it lovely, but I'm not sure, as the sun's coming that way, I'm not sure you'll be able to pick up. I can see all the sediment at the bottom of the glass. Really good. I'm gonna give it a taste, see how it is. Do it with my BB Barfly. Simon told me how to do it, but that'll do. I won't do any more. So did I show you that? I can't remember. Have a look. Let's get this open then. It's such a beautiful day. Oh, it smells nice. It smells very, it smells quite sweet actually. So let's give it a pour. Now it's bottle conditioned. Oh, you have to excuse me, I've got a really bad knee. Yeah, it's bottle conditioned, so I'm just having it cool. I'm not going to chill it or anything. There we are. Can you hear the carbonation on that? Put it close to the camera to see if you can hear it. It's not as windy today either, so you should be able to hear me better. Excuse me. Oh, terrible. Yeah, it's got a good head on it. The natural carbonation in there is wonderful. Really good. And it smells... it smells sweet. It smells refreshing, like it's going to be a good beer. Let's have a taste then. It's hot. That's very tasty. That's a very, very nice beer. It's really, it's lovely and golden in colour. And it's kind of malty, but refreshingly so, and hoppy. Tastes very, really nice. It's actually quite sweet, sweeter than perhaps I thought it was going to be. I sometimes like to have a shandy, but this here, I don't think you would need it at all. Yeah, that's a lovely beer. I'll have another go. Why not glorious sunshine like this? Just pop that there then. Oh, wet my face. Oh, there's a little bug running down there. Thank you. So, there's the bottle. And I'll read some bits and pieces off the back. Shimmy up nice and close now. So, here we are. Crafted in partnership with Ascot Racecourse in celebration of their 300th birthday. Fuller's Ascot, this is a hard word, Tercentenary Ale is a limited edition sparkling golden ale, yes, that has been bottle conditioned to give this the beer superior freshness and condition. I've got to say, that's a really good beer and it is fresh. It's yummy. I'm going to burp. Oh, excuse me. It's very light as well. It's actually a 5%. It's got 5% ABV. And in all honesty, I don't think I've really noticed that it's got that higher level of alcohol. We live by the sea. Yes, thank you. What was I saying? Yeah, I don't think you'd notice much that it was such a 5% beer. It's very Moorish, I guess the word would be. You quite happily drink these without really noticing. Very tasty and very easy to drink. It's really nice. There is a website here, but it's a little bit different from the Fuller's one I've given before. It's www.fullersfinealeclub.net. That's all lowercase. And if you can see, it's actually signed by John Keeling. Hello, John. Don't know if you remember me. I filmed the interview. There you go. Good plug there. It uses the best pale ale and Cara Gold malts combined to give this special beer rich malt flavour, which is enhanced by tropical fruit aromas from the traditional English hops. A well-bred winner from a great stable. That's quite cool. So there you go. And there's I'm so sorry, excuse me. And there says, too much glare. I shade that a little bit. Bottle conditioned. And 1711 to 2011. Ascot's quite, I should have worn a hat really, shouldn't I, for this? We've missed Ascot this year. It was in June, I think. Thank you again, Amanda, for sending this. A really tasty beer. Really, really good beer. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I guess that's everything from me. Thank you for joining me again. Check out my page. It's www.facebook.com/Mrs Real Ale, and comment. I like to read your comments and comment back if I can. But yeah. So thank you, Amanda. Cheers.